Art Martinez. I've been into Mustangs all the time, but a few years ago, a friend introduced me to the Supra, because one of my friends had a Supra, and like the moment I saw it, I knew I had to have it, you know? And once I got it, man, it was just like a dream, dude.
Just got into it.
Oh, nice.
We got a good choice.
Yeah, I think I made a good choice, too.
I bought this Supra about a few years ago from this man, and you know, I paid it cash. Is that cool or what?
I won a quarter mile car. I enjoy racing, it's my hobby, you know?
Oh, there you go, yeah, that's some max.
That's some race bred stuff right
there.
I like that he used to race, though.
Okay.
And then he used to be a muscle car guy, and now he's a poor guy.
You know,
my first car was an apple jelly Chevy.
Oh, man.
I like peanut butter jelly.
That is a clean body.
Yeah, it's real
He did
nice.
A good job with the body on that.
Sure did, look at that.
Oh, yeah. Wow, the rear end looks really good. It looks
really
good from the back.
You can see it's stock, you know?
The motor definitely looks clean and well taken care of. We won't need to wash it before we work on it.
You know, not at all. See, this kid knows what he's doing.
Yeah,
you know?
He does. He really does.
Yeah, look at that.
You guys can fine tune my car and that'd be great.
All right.
Here we go. Ooh-wee. Give me a Supra Terra. Ooh-wee.
It says, forget the dog, beware of owner.
Oh, those wheels weren't as cool as we thought they were.
No, but they're black.
They're black though, yeah. Oh, how about that front bumper?
I know, see? Hey, look at the front bumper though.
Wow.
Cool.
Fine-tune your ride, buddy.
Yeah, show us this car, bro.
The Supra's right here, man.
Yeah. I like the door right here. I like the custom graphics on the door.
Yeah, I love that.
Missing a lot of parts on this bad boy. All this trim.
Oh, no, I see. Hey.
Hey, he's got one of these, too, if you want one.
Okay. I've always been looking for one.
He's got a zip tie on the front. Look.
This car's jacked up, man. I got him. It was jacked up. Look, I don't even have a hinge to open, man. I have to do it for the ghetto style.
Yo, he's got to go under the front bumper to undo the hood.
Scoop this out, man.
Yo, but it still looks pretty clean, though. I mean, it's not so bad.
Looks are deceiving, man. It can't run for nothing.
Can't wait.
In a couple hours, this thing is going to be naked.
By
it's
tonight?
It's going to be naked.
You're going to be crying when you see it.
Damn, I'm
it's
already feeling all sensitive, man. Man, you guys soup it up so you guys
are all right, let's back this bad boy out.
Look what you do. Yup. Runs like an old lady, man.
All right, see you guys later. Okay.
We done got ourselves in trouble. This is a whole lot of work here, buddy.
At least the windshield's good.
We need a knife or something. There you go. Cut that off for me. Thank you, Britt.
Is that it? Is there more?
Hold on. There goes that. Ah, much easier. Wait. Okay, there's no air bot. There's no air filter cover. Full airflow.
I don't think the belt was designed for this car. No.
Well, we thought we were getting a car that was a twin turbo car, which is easy to make power with. And then we realized not a twin turbo car, that in fact it was a normally aspirated car.
The little flares have been bolted on and then glassed over. So we're gonna have to sand down all the way around, find each bolt, drill them out, and then we can take the flares off in order to save these rear quarter panels. Because we can't replace them. We're just not gonna be able to find the parts.
Yep.
A lot of work, but it'll be worth it. The car looks better the more stuff we take off of it.
How heavy is that?
Huh?
How heavy is
this
that?
This thing weighs like like, honestly, 10, 12 pounds,
dude. I can see your veins
popping
out when you just
pick that up. This thing weighs like 10 pounds. Just this little piece.
Screw them into the metal.
That's metal.
To create a wide body kit. Overall, you probably added maybe, with this body kit, you probably added an extra 120 pounds that you don't necessarily need that slow you down. So you can't race this.
This car just needed to be fine-tuned. You know, it's one of the legendary supercars in this import tuning world. And to see it go out like that, man, that hurt my heart.
It's just a tip on there. He didn't even do exhaust, he just has a tip over it. Boo.
Hey, Art, we were able to find you another super motor. It's twin turbo, and this time you're gonna have a little fun. You had no turbo before, but now you got two. Okay, buddy? You're gonna have fun with this one. Trust me.
This is the engine that we're putting in the car. The problem is Jay and Tyson wanted to do a dual turbo motor, and that's cool, but come on, are we gonna make the power we want?
I don't know.
No, I'm thinking we're gonna go with single turbo. We're gonna put a big one on there, shoot for 550, 600 horse. Another problem with the motor is this one's an automatic car as a standard, so now we have to find a new flywheel to make the transmission go, and there's just all sorts of problems. I have a big rack.
You have a huge rack. Okay, grab that side of the door for me, and we'll just take it out together.
I just got to get the harness out of it.
Look closer to the door.
Yeah. Get this rubber. This rubber ain't been moved in years.
Well, we just took the door off
because they're no good to us, so we'll put on some other ones, and we'll go from there.
Okay, basically right now we're getting ready to pull the old motor out so we can put the new one in. We're unbolting the cross members and all the suspension, and what we'll do, we'll set the car down and the engine and transmission will set on a stand, and then we'll go back up with it and the engine will be out.
What are you doing here?
What's up?
Where's my car at, man?
This is your car. Oh, what's left of it.
Where's my engine at, man? Right there.
You want it?
Nah,
I was thinking about selling on eBay
personally. Nah, whatever you want with that engine, bro.
Poor Art had gotten jerked around by somebody else selling him a non-turbo car and telling the poor kid it was what it was when it wasn't. So, you know, that just had my whole crew inspired to just do what we need to do and make this car run right and look good for him.
Yo, when you see this, you're gonna be blown away, brother. I know it looks crazy now, but this is just the beginning of it, man.
This thing looked like a champ.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be a champ, all right.
One word, Sabon.
It's a whole lifestyle and a lot of money put into these cars.
Hang around for more fine tuning.
All right, finally made it to Canada. I'm in Montreal for the bull run. It's gonna be crazy.
It's a whole lifestyle and a lot of money put into these cars. My name's Winnie Ramirez. I've been into modification of import cars about 6 years. I drive the JDTC Streetcar NSX.
Hey, Art. Nice to meet you. I'm doing the marketing director here at Saibon, so welcome to Saibon. What we do is we're a high-end manufacturer of carbon fiber products.
The show, I think, is really about finding good people that, you know, are in tough situations and don't really have the means to do the things they want to do, and Art is a perfect example of that.
Are all these cars fast? They look fast. They look fast, and to be honest with you, they're pretty fast.
Well, he's a hard-working kid. He does some electrician work. Anything he can do to help support his family. There's 8 siblings, and you know, he helps pay the mortgage on the house.
I was told that you had a Supra. And we make stuff with the Supra, too.
I happen to have my Supra.
Okay, but you guys enjoy it because it looks, I know it's going to look legit. You
it's going to look good. It's definitely going to look good.
Based on what I've seen outside today, those cars don't stand nothing against the Supra.
We need to do a rendering of Art's Supra. Like
the mighty Supra.
Yeah.
I was digging the Duluc kit, and I think bodykits.com has it.
That teal, we need to
bikini
drop it on.
Bikini top teal?
Bikini top teal, that's right. What it is. One day I was flipping through a magazine, I saw this bikini top, and the color was really nice on teal. I try to bring a different aspect, whether it be a peach, whether it be an apple, an orange, maybe a bathing suit sometime. If it's something I've seen on another car, I most likely don't want to paint it that color.
Pick up some other accents here and there, like we'll do the different types of wheels and stuff.
Black face on the wheels. Peel the lips out, black face, and then teal the inners out. You wanted to do some accent on the hood, right?
Yeah, I want to bring the teal up on the hood a little bit here.
Okay. So. I want to teal the engine cover. Looks good already.
Looking sharp.
Wow, that's nice.
I just wish we could build it.
Well, let's get to it then.
We can't find a 6-speed transmission. There are no Supras in a junkyard anywhere, period. So what I was going to ask you guys is, can we run like a 5-speed?
Stick with the same stock 5-speed and we'll be safe at 400.
Okay, and I've got the RPS clutch. It was for the twin turbo car. Is there any problems with going that route?
Yeah, that's gonna be a problem because the twin turbo clutch is a pull type and the non-turbo is push.
Really?
That's gonna be a problem.
This was the original motor that came out of the car. We're gonna transfer the flywheel from the US model to the Japanese model where we got, making sure that it's gonna fit right.
Because a lot of these guys are legendary in compact tuning world. They know what they're doing, man, and rare that you can find a team that can work together as well as we do and put out the horsepower that we're gonna get out of this car.
You can see how worn these pucks are right down to the rivet, so I wouldn't be surprised if it was slipping.
See it on here.
All the heat, which tells me that this individual was racing or was in a very big hurry, getting from point A, getting from point A to point B, you know?
So evidently Art was in a hurry and smoked his clutch, and now we're putting the new clutch in the car, and he's actually gonna be able to put the power to the ground and get there quickly.
I just want this car to run like a quarter mile car, dude. Well, I haven't gotten anything because all my money goes to my family, man. I mean, we have the mortgage payment, you know, we have the food. It's like 2 gallons of milk go a day in my house, man.
Okay, it looks like it'll work. The car used to, you know, have an automatic trans or manual trans. It doesn't matter. The engine is the engine. The drivetrain, the power, you know, the drivetrain part is the transmission. High performance engine with a manual trans and a factory, you know, stock transmission. That'll be interesting to see because some parts may fly.
I just talked to Robin RPS. He's got another flywheel for us, so we're good to go. I just have to send somebody to go get it.
Looks like we're ready to rock and roll and just keep going on this project here.
So what I've come up with my girlfriend here is the peacock.
I'd like to do a two-tone on the back seat.
Okay.
And I'm thinking a two-tone on the headliner too. Like I want the front half of the car above to have some color.
I love that idea. How about doing some stitching in this color? Can you find that thread or something even close to that?
I think we can do that.
Okay.
Woo! I think I'm Tyson Beckford in my Z. Woo! Watch me hit this telephone pole. Woo! I'm Tyson. I got a Z and I drifted around corners.
The hell are you doing?
Coming up?
All right, finally made it to Canada. I'm in Montreal for the bull run. It's gonna be crazy.
Fellas, get your grandma and your girlfriend out of the house, because you don't want to miss this one.
All right, finally made it to Canada. I'm in Montreal for the bull run. It's going to be crazy. The weather's great. The city's beautiful.
All right, guys, we will see y'all in Key West.
Wait for a horse.
Hey, we love you.
It's a sort of, you know, a hark back to the Cannonball Run from the 70s.
That's one of my favorite movies.
And that's, you know, we like cars. We've been doing rallies for about 10 years, but the Bull Run's been going for like 4 years in America.
Always in America, huh?
Yeah.
Nobody here has mentioned anything about winning or about rivalry. No. Everyone here just wants to get in the car and kind of have fun, huh?
It's very much an enthusiast type event, and it's a road trip. Everyone just wants to have a safe, fun time.
Good seeing you, man. Thank you so much. All the best.
The weather finally warmed up, the cars took off. Looks like they're probably on their way to meet Tyson down in Miami. I get to go back and build a Supra, though.
routine to remove the steering wheel with an airbag in it without breaking it or blowing it up in my face.
The steering wheel has to come out in order for the upholstery girls to reupholster it. And I've succeeded.
Finally! That's what I needed.
You didn't need that part?
No.
Perfect.
This one looks like the rest of the car.
When the car came in, it had a full body kit that was actually molded on to the body of the car. So what we went ahead and did was remove the whole kit and reworked everything, pretty much. Starting from the back here, we took off the fender flare that was here. And what we did was we sanded the whole quarter panel up back the way it should be, back to OEM. And obviously you see that we put the new body kit on here in the rear. Moving on to the door that we got was really banged up. It had shaved door handles, so we put that back to OEM. Up to the fenders, same thing. As you can see here, this still has part of the wide body that we're obviously gonna take out and actually rework that again back to OEM, put on the new front bumper, and hopefully everything turns out well. But it is looking good. Just have to wait and see.
Savon came through again with a great hood. I wanted to enhance the look of it a little bit, so I think it's these little touches that really make the car fine-tuned.
Oh. We gotta take this thing off. Anytime you're working on the hood, don't be afraid to adjust the fender. Because that's, you know, like, if it's gonna help close up the gap, you know, it's good. What do you think, Brian?
Looks good. Looks like you guys have been hard at it.
There was a problem with the transmission, and we think we've got that figured out. Instead of going to the 6-speed trans, we're gonna go with the 5-speed. It won't allow us to make as much power, but we think it's gonna be better for the kid. We hate to hand someone a, you know, 600 horsepower car that's never really driven anything with any power.
Hey, look at that service.
Hey, all right, guys, what's up, Joey?
We need to make this thing bulletproof. And you are the man, and we know you can do it.
Pretty simple, basic 5-speed, real durable. Can't go wrong with a Toyota.
Here at YLM Salvage Yard, and we're walking around looking for doors and anything else we might be able to use. Great thing about a salvage yard is it's pretty much a gold mine. You can find anything you need or don't need. Do you guys have any Supra doors?
Supra door?
Yeah.
All right, let's go up. Supra door.
Driver?
Yeah. I'll let you go back there. I'm gonna stay over here.
For a driver's side door for the Supra for Art's car, and right now it's not looking too good.
All right, let's check our friends over at cardomain.com.
They have parts?
They always have parts.
Sweet.
That dial, or I'm gonna whoop you like you stole something. Up next, yeah, 5-2, full run, 07, baby, yeah. Yeah, 5-2, full run, 07, baby, yeah. We're in the chase.
We're doing about 80 right now, and the rental car is just trying to keep up with these guys.
Well, we organized it because we were bored, and we wanted to do something fun.
It's quite a difficult thing to organize this. We're taking basically a couple, 250 people across the continent in 7 days, you know?
Man, genius. Have you been called a genius today yet? The two of you guys?
No, we called a lot of names.
Okay, but I'm calling you a genius right now, because this is genius how you set this whole thing up. This is fun, man.
Scion drivers, they made it. They were running, what, with 300, half a million dollar cars. And spank it!
Spank them all!
Stop! With a supercharger.
I almost got arrested. Yes, she did.
Woo! Key West, baby. We're having a good time. Get out of here!
Car arrived here at Frank's Auto Body in Huntington Beach this morning at about 7:15. We got it in the shop, started going on it. We're trying to get the body prepped up for primer and then get the paint on it. Right now we're waiting on a door, so hopefully that doesn't hold us up.
So, you know, we brought you something that needed a lot of attention. I'm not gonna lie, it was in rough shape, but it already looks like a different car just with the body work and the sanding you guys did. Pretty much all the body cars we're gonna shoot with that teal, that BASF teal we got. The hood, we got the Sebon carbon fiber hood, and we just want this front scallop right here to be in teal, and then this flat portion here. I wanna leave most of it carbon with the, you know, the side vent will be carbon, it'll look mean, but I wanna just kind of break up the lines a bit. Door that's dented on the car we have, right? We got a replacement. I think that's fantastic. That turquoise is perfect. The sun's gonna set this car off unlike any other Supra we've ever seen. The car, the paint, the body has been a mess. We finally got it taken care of at the paint shop. Now we need to get rid of the other problems. One of the things, we did not have an ECU for the turbo motor. And we called up AEM. Luckily, they said, come on down, we got some stuff for us. Kurt, Stefan, and our buddy Art, and a bunch of AEM products for us.
I'm so excited, dude. I just want to see the way it looks, you know, the way it runs, the way it sounds, everything, dude.
These guys can really make this car fast, you know?
The other important things, I think, that we bring to the table is maybe expanding the horizon of the people who own the car. There's so many things they don't realize they can do to their vehicle.
Our plug-and-play EMS, it's an engine management system, and what this does is actually allows you, it gives you 100% control over the engines.
Perfect.
We make 450, 500 horsepower all day long with the drift cars. And the drag car, we're making 1,500 horsepower on the same unit that, you know, you get off the shelf.
That's fantastic.
But the great part about it is, you know, there's so much tuning capability that you can keep drivability, the startup wheel, all that kind of stuff too.
Fuel injection, turbo boost, two-step launch control, ignition system, even transmission controls if you had an automatic. I know you don't,
but right.
And even in that case, you would. So this is for the Supra.
Basically, what the guys behind me are doing right now is pulling the turbo and exhaust manifold off the new motor that we just got. It had two turbos. We decided one would be better. So instead of two small ones, we're going one big one.
The size difference is, as you can see, a big difference. Effectively, putting more air than what these two little turbos can do, and just putting one big turbo.
The smaller turbos are only good for 400 horse. The bigger turbo will be good up to 600 plus if we wanted to.
I'm just waiting on, you know, every single day is like eternal for me, you know?
I just want this car to run like a quarter mile car, dude. I knew that this car was gonna be worth it. Well, I didn't get any of those things that I wanted on my car because all my money goes to my family. Like I said, I have a big family, dude.
We thought we'd just take the instructions to make sure that they were doing it right, but they're in Japanese.
They're in Japanese!
What starts happening when you start giving it more and more boost, things are starting to wanting to come apart, whether it's your piping, your clamps, or your intercooler tube.
We are bolting on the new tubular manifold.
It allows the exhaust air to flow a lot nicer.
If you can run a lower boost, it's a lot more reliable, and it's cool to do that and make more power than you could with two turbos.
You know, getting the right air fuel mixtures and ignition timing, the type of gaskets we use, the spark plugs. A lot of that is gonna be key in having a reliable engine.
I've never really seen one like that in the States. So that's probably what they call the JDM air filter. When you're driving down the road, all the dust and particles are blowing up, and without the air filter, it's gonna go in the turbo and destroy it rather quickly. The way you guys have it on here, it's gonna stick through the hood.
That's the point. Fresh air, right?
Fresh air.
They call this the hot side and the compressor side. This is the exhaust side of the turbo, so this gets the hottest part from the turbo.
The reason it gets hot is you're working off your exhaust. It goes through this and spins the turbine. And then this makes air sucked into here, which goes through a pipe, through the intercooler, and back into the motor.
My girls look busy.
Hey.
Hello.
I'm liking what I see. I see a lot of teal and black.
Well, we got a theme coming up. You can see it now, you know?
So it actually matches the car?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It isn't a store-bought kit. Absolutely. Somebody threw in this
right.
thing.
Right.
Aftermarket radios are slightly smaller than the factory ones. So they need just a little bit to fill in that extra gap around so it's more aesthetically pleasing.
Okay, thanks. Irwin.
Yes, sir.
Got a problem.
What's the problem now?
All the plastic interior parts that we thought we had?
Yes.
We can't have them because the dealerships takes 2 to 3 days to get them in. Mm. You know anybody that's got any pieces?
I know of a Supra.
Okay.
And just borrow it for, I mean, the meanwhile.
It is not easy to find parts for a Turbo Supra.
So, Irwin has his friend, and we're gonna borrow a few parts off his car.
Yeah.
A lot of the stock components aren't built to accept the horsepower that are on the turbo car.
Our console around the shifter is busted. So, we need this one. And it's easy enough to take out without struggling.
How are we gonna get the alternator out?
Perfect.
How?
Nice.
As you can tell, we had to pull parts off of some of our friend's car and go on a little couple special trips in the middle of the night just to get the parts we needed.
It's longer than the car.
The headlights.
Luckily, our friends came through and they gave us the parts for the interior of the car. Donnie gave us the front half, pretty much, and all the parts under the engine that we were missing. And Javier came in and gave us all the back interior pieces. So we have two friends that are willing to do whatever it takes to make sure that we get the job done. Coming up,
this Supra is a headache.
There's something wrong. Hey guys, something wrong, man.
And later.
Our hot mess becomes a hot car.
Finally, the car looks great.
I'm turning it over to your capable hands now.
Body looks slick.
Just the smidgen.
Very nice.
It's still sitting here as a skeleton, so.
So here's our resurfaced flywheel. We're just gonna go ahead and put that on. And that will go on first.
Ooh, something you need to hold this thing stable. Thank you, JoJo.
You want to hand start these bolts because you don't want to cross thread them. As you're tightening these bolts up, you want to actually torque them in a pattern, cross pattern.
There are a lot of bolts holding that on.
We are good.
Good?
Yep.
All right.
Here's your.
Nice work, gentlemen.
Ready?
All righty. We're ready to go in now that we have a new oil filter in there.
Using the old cherry picker to drop the motor in right now makes this task a heck of a lot easier since these engines are heavy.
I look like I'm right there, Joe. How about you?
This is the heart of the car going back in.
I'm lined up. Beautiful.
Good?
Nice.
That was really good.
Awesome.
Trying to epoxy the dash back down. It started lifting and it looks terrible. Trying to fix it. Otherwise, we have to replace the whole dash, and we don't really want to do that. Otherwise, it's in brake shape.
I'm test fitting the two amps. Got them sitting right here on the floor where they're gonna go. I'm gonna lay the sub against here and build a box around it. I'm gonna have a nice trim ring to go around the sub to add some depth, give it some nice 3D effect.
So we got all new bearings, seals.
Bearings, seals, synchros. You know, we down to test them for knowledge and everything, so, you know, should be fine.
Why you gotta discriminate against the tall guys? Look how short.
Well,
see, gotta make me duck down.
You gotta walk on your knees, bro.
Actually, that'd probably be just about right. there we go. What's up?
Now we're wiggling left and right to make sure that the spline catches the friction. Yeah, see? Lucky got the bad part. He's gotta wiggle up and down, side to side.
There's a little channel carved out right here for my hair. It's perfect.
And put the tiny jet.
Lift it.
It's like it's getting close. Don't breathe. We're gonna just walk it in a little bit. I don't wanna, you know, just close it on one side because then you might be cocked on the other side too. See, I was not taking much effort on the ratchet, so we have a good fit.
Yeah. Okay, cool. You already got the transient? Yeah, pretty much. We just got a few more bolts.
Okay, boys, here we go. We're gonna take this exhaust. Ready on three, come on.
What are you gonna do when you can't even connect this to the ground?
Zip tie. Make it fit,
zip tie.
Zip tie and make it fit. What about the
waist? What about that piece right there?
Hmm?
That piece is missing from there to there.
From here to here.
This exhaust doesn't fit this car. And we're going to be about this short because there's supposed to be a catalytic converter in there that was whacked up and welded onto the other car.
Wrong. Something wrong. Hey, guys, something wrong, man.
This part needs to meet this, so we need to make the turbo up here. This basically, this one part of the compressor needs to be up here. So it'll match up with this.
You take the housing out and just place it where you need it. Release the whole clamp from the back.
We got the gritty kit. We thought it would fit, but it doesn't. Nothing on this car fits. Has anyone seen the radiator?
It's inside the office last time I seen it. The exhaust manifold. Your bolts are really hard to get to, so.
That's what she said.
Taking a little bit longer than it should. At least I'm making an accomplishment right here. That right there.
Broken.
What is it?
JB Will.
The problem is the sensors broke and someone tried to glue it back together with JB Will. And normally that doesn't work so well. So problem number 285.
Plus one.
On the to-do list. We gotta go put it on the mark. All the long hours, all the thrashing, all the problems, all the conflict is worth it knowing that Art will appreciate this car. This is the new Koyo radiator that is gonna drop in and bolt in first time, no problem.
Absolutely.
It's looking like something now, huh?
Yeah. Perfect.
Okay, I'm excited. It works.
Perfect fit.
1:54 in the morning. We've been working on the car all night. I'm not sure when it needs to be back, but I know the time's coming pretty quick. We got the engine in, the transmission bolted up, drive shaft. Been running into a few problems all night, so that's some stuff we're gonna have to sort out tomorrow. We'll see how it goes.
That's some serious fine-tuning. Up next, our slick car gets a slick sound.
What'd you bring?
What do you got for us?
Brought you the flex coilovers and the EDFC.
EDFC, you pull this off.
I'm gonna go right here.
You changed motors too.
Yes, they did. A lot smaller now.
Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah, it's a lot more compact.
And instead of you adjusting it, the small cutting motor does the adjustment for you. On the controller, you get three presets.
I have a soft rod, a firm rod, and then the racetrack rod.
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
And I'll set on top.
Okay.
Okay, basically what we're doing here is replacing the old struts here and springs with the new Tain Flex coilover system provided by Tain.
All right, two down, two to go.
Now what we're gonna do is bleed the brake system. We put new calipers in there and everything. We definitely wanna make sure that there's nothing but hydraulic fluid in there. We cap the reservoir, fill it up with brake fluid, pressurize it, and then all you have to do then is just crack the bleeder valve open, and then all the fluid will be pushed right out from the top and throughout the line.
We got our Toyo tires mounted on the Sportmax wheels. We went with the Toyo Proxxis tires. It's a great tire. It's got a high speed rating, which will allow us to go to the track or on the street. Great grip and is a perfect fit for all of our cars.
Getting ready to start the engine, but before we do, we're gonna add the Castrol Syntec oil, which Erwin's doing right now.
Just playing around with the AM unit, trying to get this car to idle, get some throttle response tuning. Low throttle.
So we're in the last leg of the build where we just let JoJo tune the car and use his gear and his skills.
Ready.
Brian got paint on my hands.
It went chicken wire on the inside of the bumper. It keeps a lot of dirt and grime from going up in the engine. You never know, something might pop up and fly right up into any of the turbo.
We had a ton of problems with this build. We couldn't find a door, the transmission was different, we had to find a flywheel, the power steering pump didn't work, the water pump didn't work, but all in all, we came together, and I can't wait to see Art drive this thing.
Took you long enough!
Sucks it!
Let me try it out.
Whoa. Okay, they're good.
I think this will fit.
You think so?
Yes, sir.
My art.
Oh, okay, all right.
The SEMA build, we will do that.
We're always just wanting to get in each other's way, trying to get this car done, because it's such a short amount of time, it's kind of hard to get 8 or 9 people on one car and everybody have their own space to do what they need to do.
Art is going to be most excited about the interior. He's going to open his door and the interior is going to match the paint exactly. Everyone will know. I mean, you could take a headrest out of his car and go hide it in a parking lot full of other headrests, and he'd be able to pick his headrest out because it matches perfectly. I think he's really going to be excited with all this stuff we're doing, and I think we're really handing him a machine that's going to be unlike anything he ever imagined when he bought the Supra.
Got the Pioneer AVEC D3, navigation, radio, AM/FM CD player, and we also have the option for an iPod, which is going to sit in this glove box. You gotta remember, if it ain't Pioneer, it ain't fine-tuned.
I mean, every time we give the car back to someone, it's like I'm jealous of them because I just built them one of my dream cars, and it's like, it's gone right away. But there's no one more deserving. Art is a hard-working kid.
And we're about to give Art his car back, finally. Doing the last few details, getting it polished up. Tyson's hooking up the wheels so they look clean. We got everything pretty much in, a few more interior parts.
Hey, the horn still works. What do you know? My boy Art gets his wish.
I
right here.
Rock.
Here we go. Yo, man.
Dude, I'm like lightheaded right now.
Bikini top teal, just like we picked out for you.
Pop the hood there, homie.
That's what I'm talking about.
Show them the hood, homie. Where the hood at?
Look what you got under there, buddy.
Where are the acid marks, dude?
Where's the fire extinguisher marks? Are there a couple things under there that weren't there before?
Just that turbo, man, that big turbo with the
T78. No joke, dude.
Gretti turbo. Ready intercooler.
You got the intercooler, yeah.
Step back, let
Coil
it smile
gave us
at you.
Radiator.
See that, homeboy? Smiling at you.
It's got a grill.
Grills. And of course, different. You know, not what you're used to, huh?
What if you,
That thing's hard.
Show you the wheels. Got you on 20s.
No joke.
M10. Toyo tires. Sport Max wheels. Rotor brakes. 4-inch pistons in the rear. 6 in the front. So, yo, all that speed, you're going to be able to stop. And you got a street machine right here.
You guys could get down, dude, serious.
Oh, yeah.
1 week, man.
Oh, yeah.
That's the craziest
Seven
part
days,
to me.
Huh?
Yeah, one what? Week. That was it. Well, we
I've been
it
trying
up.
To do this for the past decade, man. So,
all right. Decade.
We didn't do it alone. We didn't do it alone.
We got suede to match the outside with some black leather.
Do me a favor.
I mean, does it even look like the same car?
Jumping. Get in the seat. Shotgun. Where's your homies, man?
Inside your roof, man.
Look at your roof, man.
You like these seatbone seats you got here, buddy?
See carbon
fiber
panel.
In the back.
Carbon fiber door panel. All Savon Pioneer system. Buddy, can't
you
get no better than that.
You got a serious ride right now.
Oh, yeah. You know, oh, yeah.
You'll beat up any car you come across.
AEM, engine management, AEM.
You guys ain't no joke, dude. Serious.
Hey, buddy. You've been fine-tuned, baby. You've been fine-tuned. Enjoy, man. Remember to come pick me up, okay?
That's right.
Come pick me up, man.
That's right.
Man, I believe it, man. They can't believe it until they see it. My idea of this car being hooked up, it was completely different from in reality, you know? I mean, I look at it turboed out, nice paint, carbon fiber, everything looking legit. I like the interior, the sound, everything completely to the max, bro. It looks great. My favorite part of the car would be that turbo, man. That's really gonna kick in, especially in the streets. Just like, sick drag racer right now, just chilling. Incredible, man. I mean, the way these guys could get down, I've been trying to work on this car for the past last decade, you know, so I probably wouldn't even get close to the way these guys took care of this car, man. 8 days? I mean, these guys, what they did with this car in 8 days, dude, working, I can imagine them working 24 hours a day. It's like, these guys can really take all their effort into this car, you know? Can't think of the work. To show my appreciation, man, these guys can really make this car look sexy and fast, you know? These guys just made my dream come true, man. Serious. And I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart.